You know how in some sci-fi movies, a group of researchers discovers something fascinating? Well, what I'm about to share is similar, but this time, it's not from a film. It's a real event. In Cambridge, a group of astrophysicists researching exoplanets was examining their daily data as usual. Recently, they analyzed the data from the exoplanet K2-18b, a hot topic among many researchers. What they found was entirely unexpected. There seemed to be something unusual, something that shouldn't have been there. Could it be evidence of alien life? This is precisely what happened to a research group in Cambridge. You might recall how the discovery of a phosphine molecule on Venus caused a huge stir a few years ago. This molecule is typically produced by biological processes. I'll explain the background of such scientific discoveries in detail. But first, let me draw your attention to something else. Have you noticed how these kinds of news are becoming more frequent? Could we really be getting closer to finding ET? Before continuing, thank you for subscribing and supporting my work. What do you think? Is there such a thing as aliens? Write as a comment. The discovery by the Cambridge group is related to the exoplanet K2-18b. Planets orbiting stars outside our solar system are called exoplanets. Planets orbiting our sun, like our neighbors, are within the solar system. However, we currently lack the capability to directly measure conditions on exoplanets. We can only send probes, spacecraft, or satellites to planets within our solar system. What is the farthest planet in the solar system? Neptune. How far is it? About 0.0005 light years. In contrast, the exoplanet K2-18b is 124 light years away. That's nearly 250,000 times farther than Neptune. To study such distant exoplanets, we must rely on entirely different methods. Fortunately, light allows us to see even what's not directly visible. As light passes through a medium, it interacts with the environment, one interaction being absorption. Molecules absorb light at specific wavelengths. Thus, we expect a decrease in the number of photons at those wavelengths. However, to detect this, we must separate the incoming light by its energies or wavelengths. To achieve this, we use instruments like spectrometers, similar to Newton's prism, to split light into a spectrum. This separates light into its wavelengths, letting us measure the intensity of each. For instance, we might observe less green light compared to red light. A dip in intensity at a specific wavelength indicates that the light has been absorbed. These absorption dips are called absorption lines, unique to each molecule, much like fingerprints. Just as fingerprints can sometimes be similar, absorption lines can also resemble each other. Since every molecule interacts with light differently, identifying these lines allows us to deduce the molecules present. For example, hydrogen absorbs light at one wavelength, while oxygen absorbs at another. If we detect absorption at hydrogen's wavelength, we can infer that the light passed through a hydrogen-rich environment before reaching us. Regardless of where light originates in the universe, these spectral lines appear at the same wavelengths. So, why did researchers focus on K2-18b? It's because, in the search for extraterrestrial life, we first examine places with conditions similar to those on Earth. Is there water? What's the temperature like? Too much heat can destroy chemical structures, while extreme cold can freeze them. K2-18b, like Earth, receives a similar amount of light from its star. Its temperature resembles Earth's, and it is believed to be a Hycean planet with oceans and an atmosphere. With 9 times Earth's mass and 2.5 times its size, it's somewhere between Earth and Neptune. Such planets, called sub-Neptunes, are common in the universe, even though none exist in our solar system. What makes K2-18b special is its hydrogen-dominated atmosphere, unlike Earth's nitrogen-rich atmosphere. Additionally, methane and carbon dioxide are also present. On Earth, these gases are often produced by biological processes, though not always. For instance, methane on Jupiter is well known to form through chemical processes under certain physical conditions. Still, the presence of methane and carbon dioxide on an exoplanet warrants further investigation. In Cambridge's case, researchers analyzing data from the Webb Space Telescope detected DMS, dimethyl sulfide, in K2-18b atmosphere. Here's what's intriguing about DMS. On Earth, it is only produced by biological processes, mainly by phytoplankton in the oceans. This discovery is remarkable. However, just because DMS is biologically produced on Earth doesn't mean the same holds for other planets. Different physical and chemical conditions could lead to its formation. Moreover, life on a planet as distinct as K2-18b could differ vastly from anything we know. Our search is based on what we understand, life as we know it. The unknown remains speculative. Detecting DMS relies on light absorption by the planet's atmosphere during its transit across its star. But detection depends on the quantity present. The weaker the signal, the harder it is to confirm. Current observations show mixed results for DMS, sometimes detected, sometimes not. This uncertainty highlights the limitations of our instruments and the complexities of analysis. In summary, while we cannot yet confirm extraterrestrial life, the presence of methane, carbon dioxide, and possibly DMS on K2-18b offers intriguing clues. Each new piece of evidence brings us closer to understanding. Next year, the Webb Space Telescope will revisit K2-18b with advanced instruments to confirm DMS's presence. As our technology improves, so does our ability to uncover evidence. Whether ET is out there or not, the increasing frequency of these discoveries brings us closer to answering one of humanity's oldest questions. Are we alone?